Fingerstyle is a great technique, something that I had to add to this course. We're going to dabble a little bit in it so you have the basic foundation of the technique. So if you want to continue more with this, you can and have a nice solid foundation. So what we'll do first is talk about the thumb on your right hand. The thumb, what you don't want to do is use too much wrist and flick your thumb away from the string. What you want to do is keep it in one place. And what I do here is just play the sixth string so you see exactly what I'm talking about. I'm coming right off the meaty part of the thumb, right where that knuckle is, and I'm playing straight down. Okay, now some guys, they actually move their knuckle down a little bit as they pass through the string. I like to keep it more consistent. I just keep it nice and straight and move it from the meaty part of the hand straight down. I find that gives me a more consistent tone, volume, and just a more accuracy on the string. And of course, you can play that for the fifth string, the fourth string as well, and even the third string if you need to, okay? But I would just practice that a few times and really get used to the thumb making contact with that string. A nice follow through here is great if you can come down to the fifth string to really practice that. It'll be called more of like a rest stroke. And then of course you can work on more of a free stroke by bringing it immediately back up so that you can prep it to go back down again. Okay, so both of those work real well. The resting stroke here, and then of course lifting it straight up again. Now for the fingers. The fingers are real important. What you need to do is make sure they're behind the thumb, not in line with the thumb. I see this a lot with players who first learn this technique. The thumb collapses behind the fingers and they try to play this way, but you don't have the clearance to follow through and your hand starts to move around, do all kinds of funky things, and before you know it, it's just not fun because you can't play that way. So what you need to do is make sure that your fingers are angled behind your thumb. And then as you play up on the string, you have a nice follow through tucked right behind the thumb. That's your first finger on the third string. Here's the second finger on the second string. And then here's the third finger on the first string. Straight up, right off the pads of the fingers. That's all you have to do, okay? If you want to move those around, of course you can do that also, okay? You can get the thumb into motion here. As soon as you come down, maybe play your first string. Make sure your accuracy is right there. If you start seeing this type of stuff, you're gonna start to move your forearm, your wrist. If you're trying to get out of the way, try to do a follow through, you can't do it. So you need to have those fingers tucked behind to have your technique really solid. Okay, the first example we're going to do is going to involve the thumb on the sixth string, the first finger assigned to the third string, second finger assigned to the second string, third finger assigned to the first string. And these three examples I'm going to play through here are all based off the same type of pattern, the same strings, just so you can get used to the right hand. You can focus all of your attention on your technique, which is so, so important, especially with when you're using fingerstyle technique. So here's the first example. And here's example two. So a little bit different pattern that you use with your right hand. And now what we'll do is take a look at example three now.